left. Hello.
Callum.
Come on.
Look,
say high five.
High fives. That's wonderful. We've got sharks on our jacket. Love sharks. Yeah.
Good morning and welcome to another Alton Towers vlog where we are here with Jesse. Say hiya.
She's a bit shy.
But yeah, we're starting off the day in CBeebies land. It's just me, the wife, and the two kids today. So yeah, they've got all the actors out today, which is good. And yeah, we're gonna check out some Scarefest stuff. Let me know what you think of the new hat design. Do you want me to carry you? No, come on then.
No, it's a little bit slow today.
So yeah, we're just hitting up some CBeebies for early ride time, which is always a good choice because it gets busy here, especially because it's the last weekend of the summer holidays. It is in fact the 1st of September, so I'm expecting to see quite a lot of Scarefest stuff happening. I know! So yeah, see if we can get any spoilers in.
Hello!
Good morning!
Oh, yes.
Big rabbit. What are you doing?
Doing this.
Oh, they're new. Not seen these ones before. Have you? Oh. Hiya.
Now that he has his train.
Jesse!
Hiya! Pierce followed around Thompson and Thompson Ground. He's counting his livestock. I'm waiting for a very important delivery. Well done!
Moo! So basically, if you've not been inside Justin's Hi-O-Matic place, it's basically just a load of air cannons where you fire foam balls at each other. Brilliant. So we already know that the welcoming isn't returning this year, but I think that this area in the courtyard is where Darkest Depths is gonna be. Because although it's like sea monstery stuff, I can't see them closing the Sea Life Center just for that. Plus this is just an area they can use. So they might as well. So yeah, I think it will be in here this year.
Have you ever noticed these before? Well, I certainly haven't. Tops of the lights?
Yeah.
If you have, let me know in the comments below. I think they're new. Look good.
So the construction walls are up for the new addition in 2020. Haven't got a clue what it is. Yeah. I just was told prior to this happening that building would be used for another purpose. So yeah, looking forward to what that's going to be. Hopefully that means a re-theme for Cloud Cuckoo Land. And we've got the dungeons, just down there. That should be good at Scarefest. Hopefully they mix it up a little bit, make it a little bit more extreme. Or just sort of mix up the storyline a little bit, the scripts, which I'm sure they'll do wonderfully. So we've hit some rides up, we've had a little look, I've had a quick sneak peek round the exit of subspecies and can't see a great deal in there because they've still got all the barriers up, but from what I can see they have added a lot more sort of external finishing touches to it, like the barbed wire and such things like that. So things are definitely happening and Scarefest is definitely on the way, and I'm excited for it. So yeah, also all them lights earlier up on the bridge in between the towers and battle galleons, looks like they've got new tops on them. I don't know if they've always been there, whether they've just cleaned them or what, I don't know, but they just seem to stand out this time. So yeah, some more Scarefoot stuff. There's 13 behind me.
We've got some lighting tucked away. Scarefest behind them, and then with these, I think they're up there for Scarefest, which will really add some funky atmosphere to this area. So they're going to be orange, and then the lights are blue and green. So yeah, that'll make a nice effect out on this bridge. There's also some more electrical connectors just tucked behind that one up there. So yeah, expect to see something along this bridge.
Is that a real tank?
Yep, that's a real tank. So here we have Project 42. Things seem to be, I think them lights have been recently installed because they look fairly clean. Them yellow lights, yellow spotlights. Can't really see a lot else. Not added any more lights to the top. The tanks, yeah, still there. Bit of sponsoring for Clark there on the tent. But other than that, can't really see a lot else. Was that Clark tent even there last year? You know what, I can't remember. I don't know if it was, it must have been. Let's see if we can see anything around this side. No, it still looks all the same. Oh, there's a bit of plastic sheeting down there. And stairs up there. But I can't really see a lot else. There's some electrical wires down there. Just tucked away. Down there, there it is. But yeah, other than that, can't really see a lot else going on, to be honest. What? Yeah, I'm coming round to Jewel, don't worry. But yeah, we can't really see a lot else on this. I mean, it looks like there's a few things been added, but nothing sort of major to report, just some lights and that gone in. Hopefully they up the smoke in this maze this year, because yeah, everyone likes a bit of smoke. So we're just walking out of Forbidden Valley, and they've got the speakers going on here, which they don't normally have. So whether they're testing them for audio for Scarefest, because I'm pretty sure I don't remember music ever being out this far. But yeah, exciting times. So Callum has decided that today is the day that he's gonna go on the Runaway Mine Train for the first time. Aren't ya? Yeah?
What are you gonna say when you're on it?
Choo-choo.
That's it, his first experience of choo-choo. I'm excited, this is a big moment. Right, so Callum, how was that?
Good.
Is that new now, your new favourite ride?
Yeah.
Yeah, what was your best bit? When it went in the cave?
Yeah.
Was it?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, new favourite. New favourite coaster. Hi, Callum. Yes. Let's get him on some of the bigger ones. So we've got some lights up there. Blue and green ones for Scarefest, as well as this side. We got some red ones. So there's, I can also see, you know, like electrical points being put everywhere as well. So that probably means there's gonna be some more lights put in. And yeah, this is exciting. The hearse is obviously out, as I'm sure everybody that's watching this has already seen, because everyone else has been posting it everywhere. But yeah, that's good sight to see. We are just where the Altonville Mine Tours queue line is, like the initial one where they check your tickets. And obviously you go through on your allocated time. And I can't see a great deal of stuff up here. I think these yellow lights have just been put up. Sorry if it's a bit shaky, I'm still trying to get used to this camera. But other than that, I can't really see a lot else, but you never normally can from here. But that's, yeah, there's the queue line. Doesn't look like there's a lot else that we're going to be able to see. There is a light on up there, but no, that's about it for the Altonville Mine Tours, I'm afraid. Because it's all behind like a massive bank just up here, so you can't really see a lot. Let's go check out subspecies. So yeah, it's still well fenced off, so you can't really see a lot other than sort of like poking through them little holes in that bottom black bit. Can't really see a lot. It just looks like they've added all like the extra like fencing and barbed wire and that sort of thing. So externally, from what I can see, it looks pretty done. You can see sort of the top of the exits there. But I mean, through there, that's where Altonville Mine Tours is, but that's sort of all you're going to be able to get. So you still can't see a lot. You can see there's stuff happening down there. And yeah, but you can't really see what. I can see a little hut, if you can make that out. But what that's going to be used for, I don't have a clue. Looks like there's a bit more there than what there was last year. Although they took the bag thing off there last year and you could actually go through with your bags. You just sort of put them on your front and took your backpacks through that way. Let's have a little peek around the side of this, see if we can see anything. So there you can see the exit of what it's going to look like. So you're definitely missing that container just there, because there was two ways out, but now it looks like there's only one. With a little probably crawl through section. So there might still be two exits, but not to the extent there was last year. Probably just be like another crawl through. And again. Yeah, it looks good. I feel like they're really gonna do something extra with it this year, because I think this might be the last year it's gonna come back. So I think they probably want it to go out with a bang, or try and lean it towards something else. But yeah, I'm excited for it. Just a quick update on the wooden trolley around the back of the towers, and it's been tipped over. Whether they've done that or whether some kids have done it, which wouldn't surprise me if they had. But other than that, there's not a lot we can see, because they've actually fully closed off the towers now. So we can't actually get through and have any little sneaky peeks. But I did notice this morning they were trimming all the bushes and cutting all the grass and everything around here, so they were probably just getting everything ready. Which I wonder, because if I'm honest, I don't know where the attic Terror of the Towers is going to be. I thought it was going to be in the building that's got the new attraction where House of Monsters was, but now I don't think it is, because it's all boarded off and I just don't think that's where it's going to be. That's where I thought it was going to be, so I'm guessing now it's going to be back in the towers again, but where we actually access it from, I'm not sure. I doubt it's up there anymore, because there's no like construction or anything going on, so I wonder. We'll come back just before Scarefest anyway, and then we will get some more information on exactly what is happening. Right, so that's going to end our day today at Altonville Towers. We've seen a few little Scarefest updates, I suppose, not a massive amount, but yeah, September, so things are only going to get more and more involved from here. Callum had his first ride on Runaway Mine Train, which was definitely worth the visit, and yeah, we will be back later in the month. Yeah, to see what else is happening before the actual Scarefest event, which I cannot wait for. So thank you for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe. And I will see you in the next one.